to the Wind Ensemble's Concert in the Quad. My name is Gretchen Renshaw James, and I'm so proud to serve as the conductor of this ensemble, the Hendrix College Wind Ensemble. And we are really excited to share a concert with you on this spectacularly beautiful day, where we are also joined by our friends from La Valley Creamery. Let's say thanks to La Valley Creamery. So I hope you'll get a chance to visit them. Their presence here today is co-sponsored by the Wind Ensemble, as well as student activities, which is why all of the folks who have Hendrix IDs can go over and get a free scoop of ice cream. So I hope that those folks are doing that. But everybody, of course, is welcome to visit them as well. So we're really excited about our program today. We're calling it Variations on America Part 2. We did Part 1 in March, so now we're going to continue in that vein. And the idea with this program, as well as the March program, is to connect with a wide variety of different American musical voices and perspectives, which we're doing, all except one piece, but I'll explain that when we get there. We begin today with the last movement of Erica Spano's Steampunk Suite, which the suite as a whole depicts various scenes that take place in a fictional alternate history centered on the Victorian era. And steampunk, in case you've not run into this interesting term before, is a subgenre of science fiction and fantasy that incorporates technology and aesthetic designs inspired by 19th century industrial steam-powered machinery. So things like trains, for example. I hope one goes by as we plan. It would be perfect. So after we take a tuning pitch, we are excited to share with you the last movement from the steampunk suite. It is called Barnum and Tesla's Tandem Bicycle.
Thank you.
March, part one of Variations on America, the concert, we had the opportunity to welcome guest composer and conductor Quinn Mason to Hendrix to work with us on two pieces. One of those was one we had commissioned, and he wrote that for us. It was called Scène de Notre Dame. And he also conducted another one of his pieces with us, Across a Golden Sky, which is the one you're about to hear. It is Quinn's musical depiction of the Golden Hour, and although we're just a little bit early, we hope that this piece will kind of put you in the mood for what I'm sure will be a particularly beautiful Golden Hour today, given the sunlight that we have. And so for those of you who might not be familiar with this term, the Golden Hour, it's that time just after sunrise or just before sunset, when the light, the daylight, takes on a particularly beautiful color, often with some reds in it. It's kind of a soft color. Great time for photography. So, speaking of photography, if any of you might be so inclined to snap a nice little picture of us while we play this, I would love to send it to Quinn. You can email it to me, french.hendrix.edu, and I will send it along to Quinn and let him know that even though we're maybe about 45 minutes too early for it, we're about as close as we could. So we hope you enjoy this musical depiction of the Golden Hour. After we take it to you, Pitch, we'll be excited to share. sometimes the golden hour, it's also kind of breezy, and it becomes an athletic endeavor up here. So kudos to our wind ensemble friends who are doing the very best they can to manage the pages and see all the music and use the clothespins. It is a real treat to play outside, also very challenging. So we have come to the program now where we have the exception to this Variations on American Theme. I have good reasons, and I'll share them with you. So this next up is a march by British composer William Walton. This piece, Crown Imperial, was written for the coronation of King George VI in Westminster Abbey in 1937. Very British, not at all American. So how did it get on this program? First of all, it's a fantastic piece. It is a really, really wonderful piece, and it's one that I grew up hearing all the time because my dad, also a band director, was in love with this piece. Insisted on conducting along to recordings of it in the car. Not at all a dangerous situation for him to be doing that, but these are my childhood memories. So that's one reason. But the other reason is that over the last few years, Hendrix has been evolving the way that we incorporate music in our commencement services. And so last year, due primarily to COVID, we utilized pre-existing recordings of music. But this year, we're going to start a tradition of recording music to be played at the commencement service, so performed by us. So in fact, on Wednesday, we're going to have a recording session on this piece so that Crown Imperial can be played for the recessional music for this year's Hendrix commencement service. So, especially for our seniors, we hope that this gets you all in the appropriate mood to graduate in just a few weeks. And we hope all of you are getting in that spirit as well and getting ready to send off our seniors out into the big, wide world. So we'll take one more tuning pitch here, and then we'll share with you Crown Imperial by William Walton. swiftly returning now to this side of the pond so we can continue our Variations on America theme. We turn now to the composer who is largely credited with creating the American sound in classical music, and that is none other than Aaron Copland. Aaron Copland gave us the kind of music that helps us imagine the wide open landscapes that we have, particularly in the western part of our country. And so, of all the incredible music that Copland wrote, for example, Rodeo, Billy the Kid, Appalachian Spring, Copland never lost sight of writing music for young or amateur performers. And so, he wrote this next piece, Down a Country Lane, specifically as a work for solo piano with the idea of amateur pianists being able to perform this at home. And in fact, the piece was commissioned by Life Magazine. Life Magazine commissions him to write a piece for this purpose, and they published it in one of their issues in 1962. And the brief article that was published along with the piece says this: Down a Country Lane fills a musical gap. It is among the few modern pieces specially written for young piano students by a major composer. Now we in the band world, obviously, don't play the piano. Well, some of us do, I should say. But we have the wonderful opportunity to get to connect with this music, this beautiful but very simple music, through a wonderful arrangement by Merlin Patterson. And so, as you listen, I invite you to imagine what going down a country lane might mean to you. This is one of many pieces out there in the world that your own lived experiences, what you bring to it, will have a dramatic impact on what you get out of it. So, for some of you, maybe down a country lane, you're thinking of the idea of going home. Maybe you lived down a country lane. Or maybe it's the idea of going somewhere peaceful. Whatever it is for you, I invite you to imagine whatever this music seems to bring to mind. And while you're imagining, if you'd like a little music theory, I encourage you to listen carefully through the outer sections of the piece, because Copland very carefully placed a bunch of what are called plagal cadences in here. And for those of you who have heard the term plagal cadence, wonderful. If you haven't, many of you have probably heard it. It's the amen cadence, right? You go along, you sing hymn, and then at the end we go, amen. Cadence. So they're in here and they are all over the place, but he's very carefully disguised them. But I promise you, you're really going to feel it once we come back and do a recap of this opening material, and really feel like we're coming home. So we'll take one more tuning pitch here, and then we're excited to share with you Aaron Copland's Down a Country Lane.
Thank you.
to the traditional close of our concert in a quad, the famous Carmen Dragon arrangement of America the Beautiful, followed by Sousa's The Stars and Stripes Forever. But before we send you all off into the beautiful evening with these couple of tunes, we need to take a moment and recognize and give a proper send-off to those in our ensemble who are playing their last concert with us. And so what we're going to do is I'm going to ask each senior to stand while I say a few words about them. And I'll ask you to hold your applause until we recognize all of our seniors. And I'll invite us all to give one big round of applause to all of our seniors, and so we can loudly and enthusiastically recognize them together. So first, we have Tristan Herschelman in the alto saxophone section. Tristan is a biology major with a music minor, and he's been in wind ensemble for all 8 semesters. Tristan is taking a gap year to work before pursuing a master's in conservation or ecology. Next, we have Victoria Lee in clarinet world. Victoria is a biology major who has also been in wind ensemble for 8 semesters and is currently deciding where to attend veterinary school in the future. Next in our front row, we have Sarah Marie Linneman, music major and psychology minor. Sarah has been in wind ensemble for all 8 semesters of her time here. Next year is taking a gap year to travel abroad and later pursuing a master's degree in music. Next in bass clarinet world, we have Maggie Kleck. Maggie is doing an interdisciplinary studies major right now, which is a law and society major, and she's pairing that with a history minor. Maggie has also been in wind ensemble for all 8 semesters of her time here, taking a gap year next year to travel and then looking into law school. Next we have Danielle Kuntz. Side note, her name is Captain Steampunk because she really loves the steampunk sweep. Danielle is graduating a little bit early, actually, with a major in English creative writing. She has been in wind ensemble for 5 semesters, and the only reason she wasn't in there for a 6th semester is because of studying abroad. She is going to enter the working world for a few years and then pursue an MFA in creative writing. And last but not least, all the way in the back, Keen, will you wave? That's Keen. Keen Salmon in percussion world is a biology major. He's been in wind ensemble for all 8 semesters, has served as our wind ensemble percussion manager as well. Keen is planning to go on to graduate school and eventually work towards a PhD in conservation biology with a focus on ornithology. And so at this time, I'd like to ask all of our seniors to please stand so we can recognize you all together. Tremendously next year, but we're really glad to be able to get to send them off tonight with a beautiful evening, ice cream, and now a couple of last tunes. But before we do that, I also want to take a moment and recognize all the folks in the wind ensemble for all of their efforts across this entire semester. We are a very friendly community of folks from a wide variety of backgrounds. The students in this group come from all different majors. Yes, we've got music majors and minors in the group, but as you heard, all different kinds of majors are represented. We also have some professors in the group, some Conway community members, even some friends from UCA. So can we just say a big thank you to all of our Wind Ensemble folks. For being over here. I hope they don't run out by the time we're done with our show. So, we are so excited to share with you now the famous Carmen Dragon arrangement of America the Beautiful, and then we'll close with The Stars and Stripes Forever. Ready? There's some audience participation on the last two. Thank you.
Thank you.